ladies. So here we are, program 13, workout 3. So we know that we've done upper and core, so that leaves the legs. I know you guys have all been excited. You always are when we do leg day. So I will run through the program. As always, 6 stations. We're going to run through them consecutively. If we have any issues, just try to work through it as quickly as possible with the least amount of breaks. Obviously, if you have to stop, do so, shake it out, and then get right back into it. Okay, so there'll be a total of 3 rounds. Like always finish your first round before you move on to your second and third. So starting here, number 1, we're doing a reverse lunge with 3 pulses. We're going to have dumbbells in our hands, and I will show you. We're just holding these dumbbells. You're more than welcome to stack them if you want, but you can hold them. So I do expect you to be holding a decent amount of weight. These are 15 pounds. There's no reason why you shouldn't be using 15 pounds, 10 pounds at the very minimum. If you have any knee problems, remember, modification, just don't go as deep into the lunge, okay? So starting, stepping it back, coming down to 90 degrees, pushing off, and pulse. 1, 2, 3. You can put your foot down if you need to, go back, down, up, push off, 1, 2, 3. Now remember, when we go into our lunge, our body is straight and we're trying to hit 90 degrees on front and back leg. Push off, I'm going to fall over, 1, 2, 3. Again, when we're squeezing, it's a small movement, we're just squeezing that glute and lifting it. That's it. So we are doing 10 on this leg and 10 on this leg. So second station is over here. We're going to use the resistance band. It is a timed one. Your timer is here. Set for 45 seconds. Again, there really is no modification for this one, but this one's very important to choke up on the band. You want it nice and tight because you want to feel the burn. So starting here, start your timer. All we're doing here, see, I'm going to choke up on it nice and tight, and we're just two steps. 1, 2, try to really widen that stance. So again, for me, I need to choke up on it because I'm not feeling it. 1, 2. You want to take 3 steps, go ahead, and that's it. So again, kind of be in that squat position. And big, wide steps. Core tight, shoulders back, and that's it. 45 seconds, ladies. Again, make sure you choke up on that band and really feel yourself trying to push that band apart. So, station 3 is diamond lunges. Doing 6 sets. So for this one, again, heavy set of weights. We're only holding them. So I've got 17 pounds here, and what I want to see is 90 degrees, push off, side lunge. Again, when we're doing a side lunge, we're making sure our knee is not checking over our toe forward, our bottom is back. You're not bowed, our chest is up, push off, and reverse. Up, this, forward, side, and reverse. So you can alternate and choose to go one side And then the other. Or you can do six on one side and six on the other. Doesn't matter. So again, modification for that would be not going as deep into the squat. That's it. But as you can see, holding some heavier weights, it's going to get your heart rate up. And number four is over here. We're doing a sumo squat with a bicep curl into a narrow squat. So this one, we are doing 10 per side. So again, I want to just demonstrate what a sumo squat is properly. So your feet are turned out, your knees are trekking over the toes, your body comes down straight, you're trying to pull that bottom, your glutes, your butt underneath you. It's like you're sliding down a wall. So you want to keep that form. You want to make sure your knees are going out and down and back up. When you're coming up, you're squeezing those glutes, okay? So none of this, nothing forward. It's all out. Nice and tight and coming up and squeezing. So for this one, we're starting here. I'm stepping out. I'm doing a bicep curl. I'm coming up into the center, narrow squat, and then stepping out. And again, there's one. So 10 of these sets. We want to make sure when we're doing our bicep curl, we're coming up just enough to keep that load on the arms. We bring it up too high, we take that load off. So again, nice tight core, chest is up, bottom is underneath, and knees are trekking over the toes. Okay, so station five is going to be our lateral squat to a lunge with a clean. So we touched a little bit on a clean and press, clean and jerk. So this is just a little bit different. And what we're doing, this is 10 per side as well. So what I want to see, and I'll show you modification for this one, but to start out, you're going to be going down, so again, chest stays up, butt goes back, down, 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 up, down, up, down, up. Okay, so modification to this one would just be simply down and up, down and up. Down and up. So again, keeping that chest up, we're not bowed over. Okay? So 10 on this side, 10 on that side. If you want to really increase your heart rate, add that jump. If you're ready, you have no knee issues, add that jump. Push yourself. And don't be afraid to use 10 pounds or higher of a weight. Time, most of you guys can do it. I know you can, so just try it. And last but not least, number six is lateral squat with a sidestep and a diagonal press up. So this one we're doing for 30 seconds per side. So your timer set for 30 seconds, and what I want to see. Because again, lateral, butt goes back, chest stays up, this, and step up. And so So just a little skip. Little skip. And that's it. So six stations. Again, choose a weight that's going to challenge you. And let me know what you think. Make sure you warm up and make sure you stretch it out, ladies. Very important. Okay, let me know what you think.